Hello friends, welcome to my channel Learn with Spoorthi. In this video I am going to explain the poem To a Pair of Cyrus Cranes written by Manmohan Singh. Before I start the explanation of the poem, let me tell you what are these Cyrus Cranes are. The Cyrus Cranes are the tallest of the flying birds. They are found in parts of Indian subcontinent, Southwest Asia and Australia. It is a very beautiful poem. It shows that even animals do have feelings. So quickly, let's start the explanation of the poem. First, let us see the first stanza. The male was shot as he necked to pull the reluctant sun out from the rim of horizon. The male was shot as he necked to pull the reluctant sun out from the rim of horizon. One morning, a pair of Cyrus cranes were flying in the sky joyfully. It was a morning scene. The two birds cranes were flying in the sky. The male bird was flying so gracefully. It was flying very beautifully that it seems to look like it is pulling the reluctant sun out of the rim of horizon. Horizon is a place where the earth and the sky appears to meet. The crane looked like as if it was pulling the unwilling sun from the horizon. Both the birds were very happy at that moment. But something happened that they never thought. The male bird was shot by a cruel hunter. The cold-hearted cruel hunter killed the bird. He shot the male bird. एक सुबह साइरस क्रेन्स की जोड़ी खुशी से आकाश में घेर रहे थे. ऐसा लग रहा था कि नर पक्षी सूरज को हॉरिजॉन से बाहर खींच रहा था. दोनों पक्षी उस पल बहुत खुश थे, लेकिन कुछ ऐसा हुआ जो उन्होंने कभी नहीं सोचा. नर पक्षी को एक क्रूर हंटर ने गोली मार दी. Now, let us see the second stanza. She flew crying as he was picked up, hands and jaws, and a proud neck was humbled to lie like dirty linen in a coarse washing bag. The female Cyrus crane helplessly saw the death of its mate. She flew crying over the death place. The bird hunter showed his callousness on the dead body of the male bird. The cruel hunter treated the male bird as a waste thing. The bird's neck was humbled. He picked it up with his hands and jaws and put it in a rough washing bag. Female Cyrus crane अपनी साथी का मृत्यु देख के रोने लगी. वो असहाय रूप में थी. शिकारी ने बहुत बेरहमी दिखाया. वो मृत पक्षी को अपनी हाथों से एक वेस्ट थिंग की तरह एक रफ वॉशिंग बैग में डाल के लेकर चला गया. दिस वॉज द सेकेंड स्ट्रांजा. नाउ लेट अस लुक एट द थर्ड स्ट्रांजा. She circled the sky in the moments of grace over his disgraceful end. The killer went away and she returned to the death scene with grief that inscribed its intensity in dots and pit like the Morse code of bird's arrow transmitted to air. The female bird expressed her grief. She circled the sky gracefully over his disgraceful end. When the hunter was gone with its mate's dead body, the female bird returned to the death scene. It expressed its grief by crying in dots and pits. The Morse code of bird sorrow was transmitted in the air. Here, the dots and pits are the short and long cries of the female bird. पक्षी बहुत दुख थी जब शिकारी अपने साथी के शव के साथ चला गया तो मादा पक्षी मृत के दृश्य में लौट आई. उसने डॉट और पिट्स में रोते हुए उसकी दुख को दिखाई. मोर्स कोड इज ए सिंबोलिक लैंग्वेज. It is the combination of long and short sounds. It is a way of communication in birds. Now let us see what does the next stanza says. With her beak, she kissed a few feathers, picked the ones that wind had not taken away, and she sat to hatch the blood-stained feathers into a toddling chick. The female bird was very sad by the unfortunate death of its mate. It showed its agony, pain by kissing the feathers with blood stains that the wind had not taken away. The cruel hunter has taken away the male bird. This female bird is only left with this blood-stained feathers of its mate. The bird desperately wants the male bird back in its life. She sat on the feathers and tried to hatch them into a small chick. It was hoping to bring back its life. वो पक्षी अपने प्यार को वापस पाना चाहती थी. वो उसको वापस लाना चाहती थी. उसके लिए वो उसका मेट का फेदर्स के ऊपर बैठ के हैच करने की कोशिश कर रही थी. बट इट्स इम्पॉसिबल. द बर्ड इज डेड एंड इट कैन नॉट कम बैक. नाउ लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट स्ट्रैंजा. इट्स द लास्ट स्ट्रैंजा. ए वेव फ्रॉम द सी शी हैड नेवर सीन केम टू हर फ्रॉम फार अवे एंड कैरीड हर टू हिम. She went away beyond Hume's world, beyond the legend and fables of human love. In the end, the female bird saw a huge wave which she never saw in her life, and it took her with it to her mate. The female bird was also dead. Both the birds went beyond the human's world. The love and affection of the female bird was not less than humans. It was beyond the legends and fables of human love. अंत में मादा पक्षी ने एक विशाल लहर को देखा जिसे उसने अपनी जिंदगी में कभी नहीं देखा. वो आया और उसे अपनी साथ उसके प्यार के पास लेकर गया. इसका मतलब वो मादा पक्षी भी मर गई. मादा पक्षी का प्यार और स्नेह मनुष्य से कम नहीं था. द लव एंड द अफेक्शन ऑफ द बर्ड वॉज नॉट लेस दैन ह्यूमन लव. द ह्यूज वेव मेंशन्ड हियर वॉज नॉट द रियल वेव. इट्स द वेव ऑफ ग्रीफ. इट्स द वेव ऑफ सैडनेस दैट टुक हर अवे. Let me tell you the summary of the whole poem to a pair of Sarah's cranes. In this poem, the poet tells about the cold nature of a killer. He do not care about the sentiments of crane. They act heartless towards the pair of the cranes. A killer shoot dead the male crane when it was least expected. He did not even give chance to save himself. He killed the crane when it was enjoying the colors of his life. He was just about to begin his day and go out to fly in a beautiful sky. They did not even show respect when he shot him dead. They carried him by his hands and jaws and threw it in a rough washing bag. He treated him like a dirty thing. The female bird, witnessing all this, started acting like some insane to express her grief. They did not care about the female crane and carried away her love of life with them. I hope it was helpful for you. If it was helpful for you, please like the video, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel. See you in next video. Until then, take care. Keep learning.